said it. Did he say it to the hearing of Goliath? Yes. He said it to the hearing of Goliath. You see, some of you, you just, you know, say to yourself, if I confess this sin now and it did not come true, people will mock me. No, David spoke out. Said to the person about to start, speak out. 1 Samuel chapter 17 from verse number 42. And when the Philistine looked about and saw David, he disdained him, for he was but a youth and ruddy and of a fair countenance. And the Philistine said unto David, am I a dog that thou comest to me with staves? And the Philistine cursed David by his gods. You see, the Philistine is an unbeliever. He does not know Jehovah. And he disdained David. He walked by sight. He looked at him as a little boy, you know, and to him, this little boy can do me no harm. So he just disdained him. But see, when David wanted to speak, hear his own words. You can always distinguish a Christian when he speaks, okay, from an infidel. When a Christian speaks, you will know that this is a Christian. When a child of God speaks, you will know this is a child of God. Verse number 45. Then said David to the Philistine, thou comest to me with a sword and with a spear and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom thou hast defied. This day will the Lord deliver thee into my hand, and I will smite thee and take thy head from thee, and I will give the carcasses of the host of the Philistines this day unto the fowls of the air and to the wild beasts of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel. His dependence was on God. The knowledge of the word of God he had was his motivation. He spoke from the word. He spoke from the angle of strength. He said to the Philistine, my God will deliver you into my hands today. Whose words letter came through? That of the Philistine or that of David? Let me tell you, before David brought Goliath down, he confessed it. He said it. Learn to say what you want to see happen. Okay? That thing you want to see happen, say it. And not tomorrow. Not tomorrow. Like the children of Israel, you will say, I talk amo. This thing, I talk amo. This thing that is happening now, I said it. Each time they met a challenge, they turned to Moses and said, we said this thing in the land of Egypt. That is to say, they were harvesting what they had already said in the land of Egypt. Why not say something today that will meet you before January runs out? Why not say something today that will meet you before February runs out? Why not say something today that will meet you before March runs out? Why not say something today that will meet you before this year runs out? What you say today will go into your future and create a harvest. There is a future for you. Your destiny will come through. You will get there. You will get there. You will achieve God's best for your life. If you believe it, shout a louder amen. You know, the book of Hebrews chapter 3 says that Jesus Christ is. He is the high priest of our confession. Hiya. Jesus Christ is the high priest of our confession. Chapter 2. Look at Galatians chapter 2. Verse number 20. Are you there? Galatians chapter 2 from verse number 20. I read, I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. Yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. Somebody shout, yeah! I'm already dead. My life is hid in Christ. So the life I now have, the life I now have is not the kind of life ordinary people have. No, the life I now have is the life of Jesus Christ, the life of the Son of God, who died for me, who took my place. So the life I have now cannot be terminated by the devil. You shall live, ladies and gentlemen. I said you shall live and not die. Somebody should give me a better amen. Somebody who is alive should give me a better amen. If you are afraid of death, if you are afraid of death, repeat after me. I am dead. My life is hid in Christ and with Christ in God. And the life I now have in this body of flesh, is the life of the Son of God. That is what you should be saying. Say amen, somebody. My life is hidden in Christ. In the book of 1 Peter chapter 4 and verse number 11, the Bible says, if any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of God. If any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of God. Don't speak as somebody coming from the kingdom of Satan. Don't speak like somebody under the influence of Satan. Each time you open your mouth, all that comes out of your mouth is, things are hard. Hey, I am sick. I don't know what is happening to me. It seems I'm going to die. It seems this one is happening. Everything that comes out of your mouth magnifies the devil. Aren't you tired? Aren't you tired of magnifying the devil? Change your mind. Change your confession. Say what God has said in his word. And you shall live. Is it not written in your Bible? Proverbs chapter 18:21. Life and death are in the power of the tongue. He met God face to face, and God reminded him of everything, you know, he had done. How he defrauded his brother, how he defrauded the Laban, everything. God reminded him. The man felt so guilty. But he began reminding God of his promises. He reminded God of his covenant with Abraham, his covenant with Isaac. He reminded God of his words. So it was a battle of words. After that, he cried to God. He said, I don't want you to leave me this way. Please don't leave me this way. Faithful Father, don't leave me this way. I need you to bless me. I need you to bless me. And then the Lord did what? The Lord blessed him, changed his name from Jacob to Israel. Some of you, when you come to God to pray, all you know how to say is, you know, I have done this, I have done that. God forgive me, God forgive me. I have done this, I have done that. Every day, God, I'm a sinner. God, I have done this, I have done that. I am not worthy, I am not this. God, my enemy said this, my enemy said that. Every day, God, I have tried this, it didn't work, I tried the other, it didn't work. Every day is complaining. You just come before God, it's, you know, always on the negative. Every day you come before God, you're always complaining, you're always on the negative, you're always saying things. Why not lift the promises of God and tell him, Father, yes, I know this situation is this way, but this is what you have said. I know. Do you know it was that kind of prayer that saved Lot? The Lord wanted to destroy Sodom. He said, I will tell Abraham. Now, when he told Abraham, Abraham took his place in prayer and said, are you going to destroy the righteous with the wicked? And the Lord said, if I find 50 righteous people as you have requested, I will not destroy them. He said, okay, why not 30? Why not, you know? He kept pleading. It was that kind of prayer or intercession or talking to God and having him talk back to you that freed the Lord. You need to carry the word of God to him. I said, carry the word of God to him. I said, carry the word of God to him. It works, ladies and gentlemen. Do you know Jesus said, when you meet a mountain, you are having everything going good for you, all of a sudden there is a problem. It has become a mountain before you. He said, don't run away, speak to it. Speak to it. And you know, he preached that message after he spoke to the fig tree. He was traveling with his disciples, and then he saw this fig tree full of leaves, had a sign of fruitfulness. He walked to it to find figs, and he couldn't find any. He now cursed it. The Bible says when he cursed the fig tree, the people heard him. He did not say it in a way so that nobody will hear. You know, let me just say it. Let nobody hear so that if this does not come to pass, nobody will mock me. He lifted his voice and said, let no man eat from you henceforth. The people that heard it, did they say anything? They didn't say anything. They traveled. When they were coming back to show you that they were watching over that word he spoke, the Bible says they looked at that fig tree. They were now the ones that told Jesus, that fig tree you cursed yesterday is withered. He turned to them and said, have God's kind of faith. Not head faith. Okay? Faith in the word. Have God's kind of faith. I said to you, if you have this faith I'm talking about, any mountain before you, you can command it to go, and that mountain will go. Verse number 24 of Mark, the same Mark, chapter 11. He said, when you pray, believe that you receive, and you shall have it. When you pray, believe that it's coming through. Now, if you believe that what you have prayed is coming through, begin to say it. Begin to say it. Don't tell me you are poor just to get my attention or make me pity you. No, I may pity you, but your poverty situation can never change. It will never change. Don't tell me that the devil is strangling you to death. I may pity you, you know, but that will not set you free. But if you can stand on the word of God and shout, Satan, you can't touch me. I am the apple of God's eyes. Sickness, you have no place in me. My body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. You look at your enemies and say to them, you can do me no harm, for he that is in me is greater than he that is in the world. You look at your empty pocket. You say to your empty pocket, you are not empty. You are not empty. I don't walk by what I see. I don't walk by what I hear. I don't walk by what people say. I don't walk by what economy says. My pocket, you are not empty. But my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Somebody shall yes. We walk by faith, not by sight. I want you to begin to see possibilities. I want you to see God at work.